Underway. Juan Carlos Osorio has named the team that many expected, with star striker Javier Fernandez leading the attack. Fernandez had an excellent season with Bayer Leverkusen in Germany. He'll be supported by captain Hector Herrera, playing just behind Rafa Márquez. Now 37, he'll sit at the base of midfield. And we expect a three-man defence. Andrés Guardado was the outstanding player of the tournament last year as Mexico won the Gold Cup here in the USA. Our referee today is Enrique Caceres from Paraguay. His assistants both from Paraguay, Jerry Vargas, the Bolivian, is the fourth official. Uruguay are without Luis Suarez for probably the whole of the group stage after he was injured in the Spanish Cup final. So Edinson Cavani plays as the sole striker, with Diego Roland looking to move forward as much as possible. It's a strong central defensive partnership with the Atletico Madrid pair of Diego Godin and Jose Jimenez. Defender Raul Arevalo and the midfielder Carlos Sanchez both play their club football in Mexico. Strong looking bench for both of these teams, but a reminder, no Luis Suarez for Uruguay because of injury. Mexican banner moves around the stadium. But in Phoenix in particular, the passing of the man known as the greatest has been felt particularly hard, for Phoenix was where Muhammad Ali passed away. And as a mark of respect, we will have a minute's silence.
One of the world's most beloved sportsmen, humanitarians and icons of the 20th century, the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali.
Damas y caballeros, les pedimos por favor ponerse de pie y acompañarnos en un momento de silencio para honrar la memoria de uno de los deportistas humanistas e íconos más queridos del siglo XX, el mejor de todos los tiempos, Muhammad Ali.
City in mourning, a country in mourning, a world in mourning. Mexico in all white, cheered on by the majority of the crowd here in Phoenix, Arizona. Get us underway. Fantastic atmosphere here as forward comes Carlos Sanchez on this right-hand side. Could be in for a lively beginning to this game. Both teams liking to play pacey football. Mexico hoping to build upon their Gold Cup success in the United States of America last year. And both these teams will have high hopes. Indeed, they'll be very disappointed if they don't make their way out of Group C, considering that Jamaica and Venezuela are the other two teams involved in the group. High expectations then for both coaches. There is Juan Carlos Osorio, the Colombian, in charge of Mexico. He's only been in charge for a short while. Appointed last October. They have a fantastic record under him. 8 consecutive clean sheets. Mexico haven't lost since last year's Copa America. Uruguay with the free kick. Taken short by Godin. Should be an interesting tactical battle as well, with Mexico effectively playing, we expect, a 3-3-1-3 formation. Uruguay, more conventional back four of Pereira, Jimenez, Godin and Pereira. Made to safety by Alvaro Pereira, but he got a whack there off the rebound. Tavares, in charge of Uruguay now since 2006, his second spell as the national team coach. For Marquez, who instead finds Diego Reyes. Moreno. Marquez. Lovely ball out to that far side, and there's a bit of room here for Mexico to work in. And the header is in! What a start for Mexico! Hector Herrera has given Mexico the perfect start. It was a brilliant ball wide, and how about this for a cross in? And Herrera gets there ahead of the defender and sends the vast majority of the crowd here in Phoenix into dreamland. Brilliant ball in from Guardado. Herrera celebrating, but the final touch there might have come off the Uruguayan defender Pereira. Herrera may very well be trying to claim that one. That might be a decision to be taken after this match. Well, no matter what the identity of the goal scorer, whether it was Herrera, whether it was an own goal from Pereira, Mexico will be hugely encouraged by the bright start that they have made. Wonderful crossfield ball from Marquez. Superb cross from Guardado, asking the Uruguayan defenders all sorts of questions. That was on Madero. Given away and picked up here by Miguel Leon. Nice skill. Uruguay can break here, but that's a strong challenge, and it needed to be as well to clear that one away from Nestor Araujo. Of a number of players in this Mexico side who won a gold medal at the last Olympics in London in 2012. How about that for a challenge? take the throw. Anymore, Rafa Marquez, the 37-year-old. But just look at the position he takes up here. It's already apparent in the opening stages of this match that he will be controlling play for Mexico from deep. Good test here for Pereira. The ball doesn't get that far. Mexico with the free kick. Throw along Aquino. The challenge. So another test then for the Uruguayan defence. What must Alvaro Pereira be thinking now? The defender whose touch took it into his own net for the own goal. He put it behind him, concentrated on helping his team get back into this match. Leon will take. Back Godin. Diego Godin, who played in the Champions League defeat to Real Madrid for his club Atletico last weekend. Unlike his defensive partner today, Jose Maria Jimenez, who was an unused substitute for Atletico in that game in Milan. Just leave it here for Javier Fernandez. Carrojo. Huge cheer as that ball is kept in by Guardado. Played infield by Hector Moreno. Can make it a ninth consecutive clean sheet. They'll start their Copa America campaign with 3 points. Long way to go though. If you have just joined us, Mexico in front. An early own goal from Alvaro Pereira. He got the final touch under the challenge from Hector Herrera. And Uruguay have plenty to do after a very bright Mexican start. As we approach the 10-minute mark. Roll out. Pereira with the throw. Cavani waits in the middle. Rahul. Pereira will take. On it as well, cleared away by Reyes, and Reyes again followed by Fernandez. More. Pereira to clear. rare touch in the Mexican goal for Alfredo Talavera. Much the first choice goalkeeper under Juan Carlos Osorio. Mexico enjoying a very good period in their illustrious international football history. Rola. Roland, who's with Bordeaux in France, been there now for 3 years. None of this Uruguay starting 11 play their football in Uruguay, but as I mentioned at the beginning, two of them play in Mexico. Which could make things interesting if Uruguay go down to defeat today when they report back for club duty. And infield by Rojo is Talavera. Marquez. I'm sure that Edison Cavani, who's chasing down the ball, has actually had a touch so far. Uruguay's Stamine up front. Marquez. Reyes. The delays have started. And the Mexican fans, from every successful pass, forward comes Araujo. Leon can play anywhere down that side. Just too strong. From Miguel Leia, who moved to Porto last month in Portugal after a season's loan from the English side Watford. He had had half a season in England with Watford, helping the club from the English Championship to the Premier League. And this has become something of a tradition. And the opposing goalkeeper takes the goal kick, in this case Fernando Muslera, the Mexican fans do their best to basically try and put him off his stride, which they're never really going to do. Barney's header. Away by Reyes. Leia. He says that is a foul by Rios. Who won the Copa America in 2011, followed that up with gold at the Olympic Games as a underage player. Here come Mexico again. His pass, decide where he wants to go, take the pace of play. Away by Talavera. It's a brave header. Foul on Aquino by Pereira. He's had a match to forget, really. At the moment, Alvaro Pereira having scored the own goal. Oh, nicely done. Three in the penalty area waiting for a cross. This time Pereira is able to make the block, but at the expense of a corner kick. Everybody back for Uruguay, in or around the penalty area. And as a result, there's nobody forward to get on the end of the long ball. Yes. Marquez. Towards Javier Fernandez, who's offside. Javier Fernandez, who'll be extra keen to do well at this Copa America, having missed the Gold Cup victory for Mexico last summer, as he was injured. It's a fantastic stadium, it really is fantastic. Clean views of the pitch for every single spectator. The vast majority are really enjoying themselves. The Mexican wave in full force. Towards Rola. Just cleared away to safety as Carlos Sanchez was threatening to get on the end of it there for Uruguay. He'll be delighted with the start that his side has made, Juan Carlos Osorio. Former midfielder, the Mexico coach, had to retire at the age of 26 because of injury. And Moreno just turns away there from Carlos Sanchez. Here's Guardado. Moreno with the crossfield ball. Fernandez dispossessed by Pereira. Came off the Uruguayan last of all. Mexico get the throw. Leon will take. He's disappearing back onto the surface. As you can see, the grey area. It's kind of like walking on a indoor matting. Now he makes his way onto the grass. Way to safety. Mexico will come again with Moreno. Done. No free kick. Good by Sanchez. Roland was the target. Came through to him. Somewhat surprisingly, Ahorojo couldn't clear it away at the first attempt. Here's Aquino. Just high from Ahorojo. Sanchez beaten in the air. This is Moreno. Guardado. Out wide for Aquino. Chance possibly for a shot here, and easily saved by Muslera, got right behind him. Just maybe the effort there could have been hit first time, but instead the little touch was made. Cavani. Jimenez. It's onside. Two in the middle. Cavani was one of them. What a chance that was. Cavani waiting in the middle. It was a beautifully timed run, it has to be said, from Carlos Sanchez. You can see there the defender at the bottom of your picture playing him onside. But he makes amends by putting it behind for the corner kick. Plenty forward for Uruguay. Header from Godin. Didn't really get anything too much on it in the way of direction. Yet to make a save of note as we reach the halfway point of the first half. Cavani's little touchdown. Rola. Herrera. Herrera again the target for the return ball, but just taken away from him and put into touch by Araujo. Herrera with the throw. Up for offside. These little areas you can see on the pitch are actually where the sun is shining through the translucent roof here, just a little brighter than in others. Let's have a rather strange effects, as I'm sure you can see there with that rectangle on the pitch. Aquino was the target on that far side, he's kept that ball in as well. Javier Aquino, who started on the right-hand side for Mexico, but has switched across to the left with Guardado going the other way. And it's Guardado now to take this throw. Hernandez and Corona stand in the penalty area. And on Aquino. Maxi Pereira. Pereira, over 100 international appearances for Uruguay. Of Leon to hit this one in, or the left of Guardado. It's Guardado. Oh, that was a nasty challenge, and we may well have the first caution of the match here. There you go, Godin having words with the referee, expressing his displeasure. I don't think Andres Guardado can have any complaints whatsoever about the yellow card. Won it back. All the way through for Pereira. Chipped forward by Leo. Referee says play on. And towards Carlos Sanchez. stopped it by Cavani. It's Lodero. Pereira. Rola. He wasn't going to get there. That may well be another yellow card heading Uruguay's way. Matias Vecino. With the challenge on Andres Guardado. Referee couldn't have been better placed, could he? Succession, one for each of these teams. Guardado for Mexico, Vecino for Uruguay. Easy away by Moreno. And you can hear the howls from the Mexican fans as Javier Fernandez is sent tumbling. Just too strong. Maxi Pereira's easy to be able to guide that one behind. Uruguay, who reached the quarterfinals of the Copa America last season in Chile. They lost to the hosts in a very ill-tempered match. Jorge Fusil and Edinson Cavani were both sent off for Uruguay, who lost 1-0. And they finished third in their group 12 months ago. They beat Jamaica by a goal to nil. And lost 1-0 to Argentina before drawing 1-1 with Paraguay. And they meet Jamaica in the third of their group matches this year. Oscar Tabarez' side up against Venezuela next in Philadelphia, and then Jamaica in Santa Clara. Surging move forward here from Uruguay. Cavani is in behind the back. Talavera with the save, using the weight of his body there to make the block. First really good chance for Uruguay, and Talavera denies them. Headed away by Aruambo. Sanchez will just lead the throw. Well, that stop from Alfredo Talavera has given the Mexican supporters renewed hope, renewed optimism. Huge encouragement. All around the stadium, you can see them, a lot standing, many sitting on the edge of their seats. Boosted hugely by this save from Talavera. Look at the run at the top of your picture here from Cavani as he makes progress. He's onside. Super ball through to him. And suddenly he was in behind the Mexican defenders. This is a great angle. Talavera spreads himself wide. And makes the block. Uruguay beginning to come a little more into proceedings now. This is Aquino. Gets away from Rola. Forward comes Jimenez. And Again, Uruguay able to make tracks on that far side. This time it's a poor ball in, though. Easy for Talavera to gather. From Carlos Sanchez. It's a Gold Cup final victory over Jamaica. It's Hector Moreno. Dutch title last season with the PSV Eindhoven. Left-sided defender. Dramatic final day in the Eredivisie in the Netherlands. Loses out, Pereira. Headed here by Moreno. Marquez. Hector Herrera. Fantastic. Aquino able to deliver into the middle. And just let it go out for the throw, but that was a brilliant piece of skill from Javier Aquino. Down with the throw. Goalkeeper's come a long way to claim, and he's done so. Fernando Muslera. Godin. Saw Roland a little bit short there. And Mexico were in. Leon. Pereira just beat to it. Here's Miguel Leon again. Get it past the first man though, Cavani. Mexico will press again. Leon with a little ball into the penalty area. Fernandez with the flick. It's away by Jimenez. This ball picked up by Hernandez. Mexico forward in numbers. Driven across. Telling connection just couldn't be made in the middle. That's a corner. A needless corner as well. Uruguay under all sorts of pressure here. Away to my right, everybody in a Uruguay shirt is either in or around their own penalty area. All but one outfield player in the penalty area there for the team in blue. Just gathered by Muslera. Pereira. It's the last 10 minutes then of the first half. Eduardo Pereira grills it with the own goal as he turned it into his own net under pressure from Hector Herrera. Marquez. Corona. Oh, superb. And he couldn't gather. Well, we have seen some sumptuous touches from Mexico. so far in this match. It could so easily have been one apiece had not Cavani's shot been blocked by Talavera. Ballon Aquino. By Alvaro Pereira. And sometimes you see players rolling around in agony and you do really wonder what they're rolling around for, but as we saw there from those slow motion replays, he certainly felt the full force of the impact from Pereira on the top of his boot. Here's the goal. Lovely ball in, and Herrera went for it. And you can see here, the final touch is off the defender. He doesn't care who the final touch came off. Victor Herrera may try and claim it, but it will go down as an own goal by Alvaro Pereira. And the Aquino seems to be fit to continue. That's how warm it is. You can see there the complete, his soaked shirt, as we see again the challenge on Aquino, and he certainly did feel the full force from Pereira. Really is a good job. This is a indoor stadium, a retractable roof. You certainly couldn't play football outside in this temperature. Guardado. Corona. Again, Mexico forward in numbers. Patient, probing play from Mexico. Corona up against Pereira. Just kept in play on that far side and put behind. Safety first from Alvaro Pereira. Mexico will really feel that they should get a second goal before half-time just to reinforce their first half display. Dardo to take. Handled easily by Muslera, who will turn 30 next week on June the 16th. Goalkeeper who really didn't come to prominence back at the 2010 World Cup in South Africa as Uruguay reached the semi-finals. Prompted a move from Lazio in Italy to Galatasaray in Turkey, which is where he continues to play his club football now. Here's Goda. Those who have adopted the fashion of having boots of different colours on his feet. Cavani's not going to get there. The flag was up anyway. Against Diego Roland, I think. Three-year-old goalkeeper. He's got plenty of joy down the wings so far in this match. Gundogan. Dramatic there. Talavera. Mexico do have experience of playing in this stadium before. They played a group match here in Phoenix at last year's Gold Cup. They drew 0-0 here with Guatemala. So this venue is nothing new for them. Bearing in mind the 2022 World Cup is in Qatar. Obviously very hot there. This stadium may well be a blueprint for the experience we're going to get in Qatar in 6 years' time. Aquino. Here's Aquino again. Lays it out wide to Leon. Leon's ball forward in towards Javier Fernandez. Good tackling. The cross came. Jose Jimenez to make the challenge. You can see Godin was beaten. His defensive partner helps him out though. Great block. Just under 2 minutes to go until the break. Slayer always knew that was heading wide. Uruguay back in numbers. Cavani had to wait because there was nobody really forward able to support him. Corona taken out. Another caution coming. And it is a second yellow card for Matias Vecino. It's followed by a red. And just before the break, Uruguay one goal down, go one man down. Didn't get the ball at all. You could argue the position on the pitch, it was possibly a challenge that didn't need to be made. So Matias Vecino is dismissed just before half-time. A second yellow card. What does Oscar Tabárez do? Does he wait until half time before making any changes? He has to make a change in tactics anyway. One would think that Roland will drop more back into a midfield role on the left hand side, and we'll see more of a 4-4-1 formation for Uruguay with Cavani back one. I do wonder whether Tabárez might bring on an extra central midfielder at the start of the second half. Well, that's the end of the first half. Mexico in front early on, an own goal through Alvaro Pereira. And Uruguay's match got even worse when Matias Vecino was sent off for a second yellow card. At half-time in Phoenix, it is advantage Mexico. Mexico 1, Uruguay 0. Indeed to be a substitution for Uruguay. On comes Alvaro Gonzalez, and Nicolas Lodero is the player who makes way, and that is as a direct result of the dismissal of Matias Vecino. The 10th of Uruguay get the second half started, kicking from left to right in this second period. Edinson Cavani with an early touch. Remember, for Uruguay, Luis Suarez is out injured at the moment. He was injured in the Copa del Rey, Spanish Cup final, a couple of weeks ago. And Uruguay, you have to say, really have missed his presence up front. The presence of one player in this second half. They're going to play the whole of this second period one man light. Foul on Pereira. If you have just joined us, Alvaro Pereira with an own goal in the fourth minute under pressure from Hector Herrera, and then Matias Vecino sent off for two yellow cards just before half time. Carlos Sanchez will take this free kick then for Uruguay as they look to get back on level terms with this early move forward. Leg up on this near side. Round of 16 at the last World Cup in Brazil before losing to Colombia. It's the semi-finals of the 2010 World Cup in South Africa, losing to the Netherlands. What a finalist last year at the Copa America. And this last time in 2011. That's confirmation of the substitution. Alvaro Gonzalez on for Nicolas Lodero. Taking up a role on the left-hand side of the Uruguayan midfield. Uruguay Rios. It looks like playing 4-4-1. That might well be a free kick, and indeed it is. Reyes with the challenge. Carlos Sanchez. Set pieces may well present Uruguay with their best opportunity of getting a goal. With just the one man in attack in Edinson Cavani. Corner kick. Sanchez will take. Powerful header, Cavani. Oh, that almost trickled in. Uruguay so close to getting back on level terms. The initial header down, Cavani couldn't quite get there, and neither could the goalkeeper. And this time Mexico able to clear, but that was a nervous moment for the team as they tried to protect their 1-0 lead. Guardado is down. Challenged by Rios. Dado, who was booked, incidentally, in the first half. And then moments later, Matias Vecino received a yellow card for a challenge on Guardado. That was the first of his two. Nervous moments here for the goalkeeper as the ball came in towards Cavani, and it just brushes off the legs of Talavera. And he was extremely grateful it passed behind for the corner. So with Guardado off the field of play, receiving attention. Now temporarily, 10 against 10. Fernandez. Back towards Javier Fernandez. Two nice runs. Javier Fernandez. Not to be in front so far. Forward comes Aquino. Very impressive in the first half. Arujo. Jose Jimenez, chase on for Cavani, touch was by Marquez, and Cavani puts pressure on here and wins it back for Uruguay. Support from Sanchez. New man is Alvaro Gonzalez, gives away a free kick. Area, Juan Carlos Osorio. Sanchez's ball cut out. So in the penalty area waiting for a cross if this ball can be delivered. Pass two, but Corona couldn't find the fist to get past the third one. Pereira, Cavani, Corona wants it on this set near side, I think he's going to be ignored though, Dardo making tracks but eventually stopped in them. Cavani, was foul. Take responsibility now on the shoulders of Edinson Cavani. He can just fashion himself an opportunity and then take it. Chances have been few and far between so far for the Uruguayans. For Mexico, I think Lozano is going to come on. And it's Javier Aquino coming off, which is perhaps a little bit of a surprise, it has to be said, given that Aquino was most impressive in the first half. So Aquino is replaced by Lozano. A striker, just 20 years of age, only made his international debut in February in a friendly against Senegal. With Pachuca in Mexico. Now, if he lives up to the promise he's made already, he might not be there for too much longer. Talavera. Championship side Huddersfield when Miguel Layán made his debut for Watford, having joined them. Seemed a little sort of out of sorts in those rather humble surroundings in Yorkshire and England. Dado with the free kick. Moreno again. Terrific ball, but offside. Flag raised against the newly introduced substitute, Irving Lozano. It's often said that it's more difficult to play against 10 than it is against the full complement of 11, and Mexico may well very find this in the second half. Edinson Cavani has two in the middle. If he can put the ball in, prevent it for a corner. No, it isn't. Kiss with the header away, and quickly across goes Carlos Sanchez to take this corner kick for Uruguay. Chance for the shot. Oh, that may well have gone in. The flag is up. It's offside. Wouldn't count even if it had gone in the net. But the initial shot there, cannon back into play off a Uruguayan player. Had it not done so, we might have been looking there at the equaliser. All kicked away by Lozano. Better from Uruguay in this second half so far in terms of their attacking play as they chase the game. Muslera. Corona. Maxi Pereira as the initial defender, and then it was cleared away for the throw. Check to Moreno will take. Well won by Gona. And he's still going here, Diego Gona. Cavani. Chance for Uruguay, but they don't take it. What a chance that was. Diego Roland with the final shot after the magnificent run forward from Diego Godin. Look at the interception here inside his own half, and he just keeps powering forward, the Uruguayan captain. Cavani with the ball into Roland. Had to put it onto his left foot, though. He hit it first time with his right foot. Maybe we'd have been looking at 1-1. Chance at the other end. Free kick. Yellow card. Jose Jimenez. Sean Yellow. And a challenge there. Javier Fernandez. the change for Uruguay. It's going to be a change actually for both teams. Diego Roland is withdrawn and Abel Hernandez is on in his place. And a change for Mexico as well. And it's Jesus Corona who is coming off and Jesus Duenas is coming on in his place. Duenas only made his international debut last year. Member of the squad that won the Gold Cup last year. And his initial job here is to help out his defenders. Mexico with the free kick then, comes off the wall, comes off Cavani, falls to the new man. Away by Herrera. An hour played in Phoenix, Arizona at the University of Phoenix Stadium. Mexico leading the 10 men of Uruguay by 1-0. Vecino sent off just before half-time for a second yellow card. Alvaro Pereira with an own goal after just 4 minutes under considerable pressure from Hector Herrera. Already Abel Hernandez being spoken to by the referee. Who plays for Hull City in England, helped Hull return to the English Premier League via the playoff systems from the Championship only last month. Away from me, a group of Uruguayan fans, and they all put their heads in their hands and gasped as that ball nearly fell to their man inside the penalty area. Long throw then from Maxi Pereira. Uruguay will come again. Hernandez with those bright pink boots standing out. Fortunately for Uruguay, his play there wasn't stand out. Jimenez. That's Cavani, couldn't get there though, drawn by Moreno. Cavani. A little touch infield and Uruguay might be here through, but defensive cover was there. And Mexico may come again, picked up again by Jimenez. As though they've gone to a three-man defensive system now. Mark Guardado. All the way to safety by Maxi Pereira. And again, Mexico come forward. Duenas. Pereira with a little touchback. Duenas. Goalkeeper comes and one-handed punches it away to safety, but not too far. Driven across, but wide. It's a goal kick, despite the best attempts of Hector Moreno to try and claim a corner. Period of concentrated Mexican pressure. All the time, it is only Mexico 1, Uruguay 0. The 10 of Uruguay will feel they have every opportunity. And the 11 of Mexico and the thousands of Mexican supporters here in Phoenix will be a little nervous. Alan Cavani, and I just wonder whether this, although it's quite a distance out from goal, because of its position, which is virtually centre of the pitch, whether this, as you can see there, might be one that Uruguay will look to take full advantage of with a direct shot on goal. Cavani drives it straight into the wall. Appeals for handball, not given. Maxi Pereira. Guardado, the unfortunate player on the end of it. Alvaro Pereira, who scored the own goal early on, that is the difference between these teams. Here's the free kick. Struck the hands there of the Uruguayan player. Maxi Pereira gets the caution then. Chance for Mexico. It's a lovely ball in and turned towards goal, but there wasn't quite enough on the touch from Javier Fernandez. You see Hernandez making the run into the middle here. Got a touch to it, but not quite enough. South America as Chicharito, the little pig, got a little touch. Away from Maxi Pereira, and Mexico have a man free on this near far side. Taken easily by Muslera. Cavani there's a word or two for several members of the staff in the dugout just down below us for their reaction to that challenge. North official Jerry Vargas from Bolivia fully involved. As emotions run a little high in the technical areas. The keeper comes to try and claim it, doesn't do so, and he's stranded now. Can Uruguay take advantage? Well, the decision from Alfredo Talavera there to come for the ball was almost catastrophic for his side. Look how far the goalkeeper comes, and suddenly Uruguay have an opportunity. Well, you can see why Edinson Cavani there was appealing for a corner, which he should have got. And no particular member of the Mexican coaching staff sent to the sidelines. Good. Muslera. Towards Hernandez. Jumping in. Sanchez just bundled over. Godardo, you can see why the Uruguayans are asking for a yellow card. Godardo already on a caution from the first half. Now what is the referee doing here? Oh, he has! He has given him a second yellow card. Andres Godardo is sent off. And you can't help but feel that the Uruguayan players' protests to the referee played their part in his decision. Mexico are down to 10. So for 17 minutes, plus whatever additional time we're going to have, it is going to be 10 against 10 here in Phoenix. Uruguay looking for the equaliser, and they've got it as well! Diego Godin with the header, and Uruguay are back at one apiece. You can hear the boos from the Mexican fans. Insult added to injury. Godardo dismissed. And from the resulting free kick, Diego Godin makes it 1-1. Floated in here by Carlos Sanchez. And the captain leading by example. Powerful header past Talavera. And that has given Uruguay a massive boost. A huge blow for Mexico. And a decision by the referee to send off Andres Godardo will no doubt be debated rather hotly in Mexico after this match. could be a fascinating final 15 minutes. Kill Mexico with Moreno. Way to safety by Maxi Pereira towards Cavani. Taken down by Marquez. Leia. Duenas. Lozano. Right across the six-yard area. Javier Hernandez was making the run in. See him there on the edge of the penalty area, suddenly sprint forward, but he was never really going to get anywhere near that ball. On the substitute, Irving Lozano. Stays this way, it will be the best possible result for the other two teams in Group C, Jamaica and Venezuela. Venezuela having defeated Jamaica earlier today. So as it stands, Venezuela are top of the group. Able to bring Lozano into play. Muslera gets down to deny the 20-year-old. Miguel Leia. Looking to get a shot away, you feel. Lozano. Away by Pereira. Picked up by Hernandez. Here's Cavani. Hernandez making the run ahead of him. Nobody on this near side if Uruguay could work it across. And now they do. Equaliser for Uruguay. Field by Pereira. Jimenez, crossfield ball. Looking for Pereira. Lozano with a little touch. Moreno. Duenas is on this set near side. Can't be found though. Great chance this for Irving Lozano. Muslera getting down well. Pereira dispossessed. Lozano coming forward. Hernandez in the penalty area. Hernandez had made the run towards the near post. Lozano sent it right across the area, and eventually it's well wide. The effort from distance from Herrera. Third and final change coming up for Mexico. See again the interception here. Poor choice of pass from Lozano. Raul Jimenez, the striker from Benfica, is going to come on. There he is. Okay, Hernandez is the man who's going to come off, so it's going to be like for like. You can really feel the tension inside the stadium here in Phoenix. Both sides desperate to win their opening Group C fixture. Equally, just as desperate not to lose it. And would come Uruguay again. Rojo. And still, Jimenez waits to come on, waits for a break in play. Lovely ball through. Excellent defending. Oh, that was superb defending. And not for the first time either, from Jose Maria Jimenez to deny Javier Hernandez. Hernandez, who we understand is about to be replaced shortly, makes the run through. And across goes Jimenez. Wonderfully timed tackle. Javier Hernandez goes off. Mixed reaction from the Mexican supporters as the superstar of the team is withdrawn. Raul Jimenez is on in his place. And his first job is to come forward and try and get on the end of this corner kick. Might drop here for Moreno. That's another corner. Brilliant from Jimenez tonight. Two outstanding challenges. Change from Uruguay. Third and final one for them. Off comes Carlos Sanchez. And on in his place comes Gaston Ramirez. Who spent the second half of last season on loan in the English Championship with Middlesbrough, helping them to promotion. There's a yellow card shown here to Diego Godin, and I think the captain has basically protested a little too much in the opinion of the referee. Enrique Caceres, the Paraguayan official, shows yellow to Goda. It's a crowded penalty area. Couldn't quite be gathered at the first attempt. Oh, what a goal! What a goal! Rafa Márquez has surely won it for Mexico. Listen to that noise. The corner appeared to be meandering nowhere in particular. But then, you can see Marquez there as he stops. There's not really too much room for a backlift, but he gets so much power behind the shot, and it flies past Fernando Muslera. And Uruguay are in danger here, not only of losing the match, but losing their composure and discipline. It was an absolutely superb strike from Rafa Marquez. Can Uruguay come back for a second time? Towards Abel Hernandez, only just wide. Shot fired in from Gaston Ramirez. All around the stadium, Mexican supporters are celebrating and counting down the minutes until full time. Godin. Uruguay free kick. Everyone will come forward now in a blue shirt to try and get on the end of it from Alvaro Reyes. Herrera's ball forward. Ramirez. Contrasting emotions there from the two sets of supporters. The long throw from Pereira. It's towards Cavani. Uruguay need to work it across goal, they can't do so. Ivan Hernandez loses out. Mexico need to get this ball away any way they can. Pressure still on. Just too strong from Alvaro Gonzalez. The goal again. Very little in the way of approach from Rafa Marquez. Pereira just stops Herrera in his tracks. Hector Herrera can't keep it in. Uruguay throw. There's an air of panic now about Uruguay's play. As we head towards the 90-minute mark, plus whatever additional time is to be played. Ball by Pereira. In the penalty area for Uruguay. That was always going wide. Ron Godin, who is now effectively playing as a striker, the central defender. Tanabella take as much time as he possibly can over restarting play as we tick towards the 90-minute mark. official. Assure us there will be a minimum of 4 minutes additional time. Hector Moreno with the throw for Mexico, who lead by 2-1. Here's Jimenez. Free kick. Clever play from Raul Jimenez. I do wonder whether at the final whistle the referee might be the target of continued vociferous protests from the Uruguayan players. They feel that an injustice has been done today. Jimenez. As long as Mexico can just keep possession. Ole, ole for every successful pass between a player in white. And forward they come again. Back across goal, and it's a third for Mexico. Herrera with it. Set up by Diego Reyes, and that settles this Group C match. Uruguay pressing forward, having to search, having to probe, and Mexico took full advantage. Clearly onside on the near side as it's picked up by Lozano. Look at the top of the picture there as Herrera makes the run in. It's a lovely little flick across to him by Reyes. And he wasn't going to miss from there. Smiles under sombreros. Another yellow being administered by the referee. Jimenez. Thank you, Brigade. Came a long way to try and get on the end of that Talavera. Thrown out from Maxi Pereira. Who will it drop to? A Mexican. And Mexico might be away here. It's 2-1. The ball is played across properly. Mexico could be in for a fourth goal. Turn is by Duenas. Two at this far post. Muslera was always going to get on the end of that. It was a rather desperate header from Jimenez. Forward come Uruguay. Remember, it's a minimum of 4 additional minutes, and those 4 minutes have elapsed. And Uruguay have been beaten by Mexico in Group C. A huge victory for the Mexicans. Alvaro Pereira with an own goal. Then we had two sendings off. Diego Godin with the equaliser, but then Rafa Márquez and Hector Herrera won the points for Mexico. It's a match that will be debated for some time to come in both Uruguay and Mexico. What a game it was. What a spectacle it was. And it has finished in Phoenix with Mexico taking the points by 3-1.